Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I want to talk about perhaps maybe the most obvious use case of lambdas that I've never talked about before. It's just such a simple, trivial thing, and I don't know, this is probably going to be a short episode, but we'll see how it goes. Here's the basic idea. I've got a variant of some sort. And it might be, say, an int, or a double, or a string, or something like that. The both advantage and disadvantage to variant here is that the actual type is something that is known at runtime. It is not known at compile time. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains. Today we need tools that help us work quickly and effectively. CLion is a powerful JetBrains IDE for C and C++ that makes filling this need its main goal, integrating code analysis, refactorings, and a wide range of tools into your day-to-day development. The latest version of CLion introduces deep integrations with the ReSharper C++, Writer C++ language engine, performance improvements for the debugger, new features for embedded development, and enhancements for project models and build tools. Use the code CPPWeeklyCLion to get 25% off when purchasing a new CLion subscription or renewing your existing one. If I wanted to somehow, say, print this thing, this is simply not going to compile, and it can't compile because, well, I need to include the print header. And then I'm not even sure I'm on a compiler that supports print. But the point being, I can't print something with a compile time known format string that is a runtime known type. How do I go about printing it? We've talked about standard visit a fair bit in this show. You're going to get some sort of value that you want to visit and some sort of visitor that you want to apply to the variant. At the most absolute simple case, I can provide a generic lambda as my visitor. This is going to compile. This is a lambda that's not going to do anything with this value, but it's definitely a thing and it will compile. So why did I make this generic lambda, and what will it do for me? It will let me print this thing. From in here, I am now able to say print this value. And I am printing whatever the runtime type known value of the variant happens to be. We're dealing with a combination of things, the first being that variant is relatively slow to compile, and then the next being that visit is relatively slow to compile, and the final thing being that our standard print facility is also relatively slow to compile. It is considerably slower, in fact, to compile than the libformat standalone version of print. This kind of makes sense. Because of ABI reasons, our standard print and print line kind of have to all be implemented in headers, and so we're compiling the entire print and format facility every time we go to use this, which is not the case when we are using libformat. Let's go ahead and execute this and also give it some actual runtime known value. If I do return 42, then it is going to implicitly construct a variant with the runtime type of int, and then we're going to properly get the int version of this called. The interesting part of this is, why does this actually compile and work? And I will do my best to dig into that for a moment. As we can see, 42 was in fact printed. So why does this work? In the simplest sense, we have some sort of lambda structure that was created for us by the compiler. It has a templated call operator overload that takes a const reference of some unknown type. Now, if you're in C++ 20, then you can do this the exact same way by simply putting auto here, and we don't need the explicit template parameter, just like in the lambda case down on line 18. I can pass an object of type lambda to the visit function, and I'm going to get the exact same behavior. what the visit function has done for me here is create at compile time code that does something like this. So if you watched my episode on dealing with function pointers to overload sets, then you have some idea here that you can't simply get a pointer to an overload set or a pointer to a templated function, but we can pass some sort of object that itself has a templated function. And that's what we're seeing here, is the visit function provided by the standard library for us is kind of unrolling all of this code, and it's checking for each of the possibilities. Is this an int? Is this a double? Is this a string? If it has one of those possibilities in the order specified in the variant description, then it will attempt to call that callable thing with that value. So I am getting a different version of the call operator generated for each of the possible types that it might be here. If we were to dig into this debug code, we should see different versions of this generated for each thing. So we have here the int one that takes a const int reference, and then we see a call to the one that might possibly take a double, and then we see a call to the one that might take a string. There you go, generic lambdas as themselves visitors, with the entire point of the generic lambda to then call an overload function on your behalf. We can use it here in this case to quite simply just print the current value of a variant by letting the compiler unfold all this stuff for us. Well, I thought that was interesting. I'm going to talk a little bit more about format and such in an upcoming episode or in a previous episode, depending on what order I air these in. So I hope you enjoyed this. Be sure to subscribe, and I will catch you in the next episode.